Hey, Peter Gregg, live from the Christmas room. How you doing today? I got a question to answer, and it's basically about the 5D Mark IV, which I love talking about the 5D Mark IV.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Okay, here we go. We got a juicy question today. Hey, Peter. Hi. This is from YouTube. Are you all of YouTube? Well, this person, this guy, this gal, named themselves YouTube. I haven't seen that before. I have three cameras in mind, but I can't decide if I should buy the Canon 5D Mark IV, ding, or the Nikon D750, ding, or the Sony A7R II, ding. Well, that one doesn't get that big of a ding. I'm an enthusiast, and I want to buy a full-frame overall camera photography for photography and occasional video. Please suggest. Okay, for photography. Now, the first thing that I always need to know is what kind of photography are you doing, Mr. YouTube? Mr. Tube. I'll call him Mr. Tube. But what if it's a lady, Miss Tube? Is there a way I can use for Mr. and Ms. in one when I address somebody? I don't think so, but if there is, I'm sure somebody will let me know. Teach me. All right, so that he wants to know the difference in the choices between the 5D Mark IV, beautiful new camera, the D750 from Nikon, superb camera, and the Sony A7R Mark II, very good camera, okay? Now, the one with the highest megapixel is the Sony. So if you're a megapixel buyer, let's say you when you buy a car, it's like, I just want the one with the most horsepower. I don't care about anything else. Then you want the Sony because it's got 42 megapixels. 30 megapixels with the 5D Mark IV. And what's in the 750? I don't remember, but I think it's 24 or 28. Okay. So the best of the three, if you don't count video, is the 750, the Nikon 750, in my opinion. It's got no AA filter, but then neither does the Sony. It's got video recording, and all three of them have video recording. The 5D Mark IV has got a super ace up its sleeve. It's got the dual pixel focus, which is mamma mia, creme de la creme, mwah, the best. The autofocus that you're ever going to see anywhere on this planet is the dual pixel autofocus. Okay, so if you want my Italian version of Italian soup, not soup, I don't like soup. Well, I can do it, but lasagna. Have a hard time. Manicotti. Manicotti with a little extra marinara sauce, please. Yeah, no, I want two logs, not just one. So if you want the ooh-la-la for focusing, both for regular focusing and for video focusing, then your 5D Mark IV, okay? If you want a camera without an AA filter, then you've got to take out the 5D Mark IV and go with either the D750, ba-dum, or the Sony A7R Mark II, ba-dum. Now, color science, which means how they handle colors. I think Canon does it best. I think Nikon is like right up next to Canon, and I think Sony is down the line down here. So if we do it like this, Canon's color is up here, Nikon's is like right up underneath, and Sony's is down here. So I would knock out the Sony. Now, a lot of professionals use the Sony, so I'm going to put links to all three cameras down below. I'll put them on Amazon. Okay. Now, when you click on the link for, let's say, the D750 or the 5D Mark IV or whatever, it's going to take you to the page where it wants you to buy it. So if you actually buy it there, it's going to give me a commission. Yay! Ding! I get a commission. It's not much. Don't get excited. However, the interesting and the important part that I try to mention over and over is read the reviews, because people love to talk. Listen to me. I just blah, 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 blah. Okay, and they'll tell you what they like about the camera and what they don't, and you've got review after review after review, comment after comment. So read them. Click on the links below and go read them. It's important. Okay, so out of those three cameras, my favorite camera, okay, I've knocked the A7R Mark II. I keep saying A7S because that's on my mind. I knocked the A7R Mark II out of the picture. The color science is not up to par in my accounting, but even higher. I think an important part of a camera is the flash system. Okay, the Canon and the Nikon have flash systems that are by far second to none. So the Panasonic, which I love Panasonic, Sony, Olympus, Fuji, all these cameras have on the flash system. It'll flash. You could buy a flash. You could put it on the hot shoe. But you mentioned that you want to do photography, but you didn't mention what you're going to do. Take pictures of the stars at night? Are you going to take pictures of sunsets and sunrises? You don't need flash, okay? But are you going to take pictures of birthday parties, anniversary parties, going to the car show? Are you professional? Do you do events? Do you do weddings? Do you do bar mitzvahs? Do you do parties, anniversaries, business events, and stuff like that? In that case, flash will become super important. So that knocks out the Sony. So now we've got the Sony and the Nikon. Now you want to do video. They both do video. One will only do 1080. The other one will do 4K. The Canon 5D Mark IV will do 4K. The 750 will do 1080. So if you want 4K and you want it on the Nikon side, you've got to downgrade to the D500 or upgrade to the D5, which is a lot of money. A lot of money. All right? So they both have a professional level flash system. Now, when you add a video to the mix, which you did said occasional video, you want it to be pleasurable. You want to enjoy doing the video, right? The negative side is the Canon 5D Mark IV gives you a video file that's really, really large because they think they're focusing in on quality. So they're trying to give you the best video quality you can buy. So what's the gotcha? The gotcha is that it's a large file, okay? And it's a little difficult to work with. But you can get around that because I have figured out how to get around all that. So we've got that going on. So my pick would be, ding, the 5D Mark IV. That would be the one that I would suggest. All right, that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I'm live from the Christmas room. Thanks for asking the question. If you got more questions, I'll do more videos answering questions. Do you like that or you don't like that? That's up to you. But it's a way where I can communicate with everybody on a particular question. So Peter Gregg, live from the Christmas room. Thank you to everybody that's my subscriber. Catch you later. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.
Hi, everybody. It's Jingle Bell time. Yeah, this is Jingle Bells. And we're just having a good time together. And now he's much more awake. So he wanted to say hello to everybody. Hi, everybody. I'm licking Peter while I'm saying hello, okay? This guy is a licker. Oh, my God. He licks everything. Stop. I can't stand licking. So anyway, I got a dog that loves to lick, and his name is Jingles, Jingle Bells. His name is not technically Jingle Bells, okay? But when the dog's name is Jingles, what's going to come naturally? Let's say when you're in school and they try to give you nicknames based on your name. If your name is and you're in the phys ed department and your name is Jingles, the coach and everybody else go, hey, Jingle Bells, get the lead out, move. I'm not yelling at you. I'm not yelling at you, baby. I'm just pretending. So that's why I say Jingle Bells, because it's just natural. So now this part of the video is not part of the camera video. It's our Jingle Bell time. So that's what we got going. All right, catch you later. Bye-bye.